Hey guys, I'm meteorologist Bridget Mahoney again, and we are talking about something new this time. Earlier, I was talking about, of course, the severe thunderstorms from last night, but actually tonight, something pretty cool is going on. I will say this, it happens every single year, but it's peaking tonight. So that thing is the Perseid meteor shower. I'm sure a lot of us have heard about this. We've all heard about meteor showers, and it actually happens every year in the month of August. It's considered one of the most impressive, but not necessarily the largest meteor shower of the year. The reason it is kind of a better shower to see is because of the time of year it occurs. It occurs in the summer months for us in the northern hemisphere. So that means the conditions are a little bit more favorable, a little bit warmer to get out and view the meteor shower. So what is a meteor shower? I know we oftentimes see it as fireballs kind of going through the sky, as well as meteors running through the sky, but it's really because of comets that run through our solar system. And really, ultimately, it comes down to comet dust that is left behind. So this Perseid meteor showers is specifically from a comet, technically called 109P Swift Hubble, I believe, which actually has an orbit or a period of 133 years. So that's how long it takes for it to go around its entire orbit. If we can get that website up, we'll be able to show you visually how this actually interacts with the orbit of the Earth. And the last time it actually entered into the inner part of the solar system around the Earth was in 1992. So within a lot of our lifetimes, this got close to the inner rings of our solar system. And now currently the comet is actually not in the inner part of the solar system. It is in the outer part of the solar system. But actually, as this comet comes through, it leaves behind what we call debris. And that's exactly what the meteor shower is. It's us encountering that debris. And the reason it happens this time of year, we're actually in our orbit where that debris is left behind. So that's exactly why we are going to be seeing it. And it's peaking overnight tonight. Tonight technically is the best night to see it, but the further out you get from tonight, you can still see it, but the further out you get, it actually isn't going to be quite as bright. But within a few nights, it might be even better to see it for us. And that's mainly just because of the weather we are seeing over our area. So after midnight is probably the best time to see it. That's because, of course, the sun actually, here's that website, you can see the rings of the solar system, and where you see a lot of that bright kind of white, that's the debris that's left behind from the comet. So again, tonight after midnight is the best time to watch, technically the best hour to watch. That will be from 3 to 4 a.m. Early in the evening, you actually can still see a few meteor showers. But the later in the night, you will see more meteor showers. If you go out earlier in the evening, they're going to be harder to see. But those that you see in the early evening, they actually will last a little bit longer, and they may be a little bit brighter if you can see them. Through the night, you'll see more of the meteors, but they're actually going to be really quick. You got to keep your eye to the sky. They will last likely less than a second. The good thing about this meteor shower is it can be seen in all directions of the sky, especially as you head later in the evening. So you don't necessarily need to look north, look south, east, west, look wherever, but they actually recommend you to look about halfway up in the sky. And there's a few things you can do as well to make sure you see these meteors better. First, allow your eyes to adjust. Don't go out and don't be looking at your phone and then looking at the sky. I know a lot of us likely want to catch that on our phone with a video. It's that time of age where we all want to see it on our phone. But make sure just look at the sky. Don't look at any lights. That being said, also, if you go out in the country where there's not as much light pollution, that will help you as well. The light from the city actually will really take away from that. Also, something to consider tonight, which we have absolutely no control over, is the moon phase. It's a waning crescent, so it's about halfway illuminated. That could detract a little bit from our viewing. So it's not necessarily the best moon phase, but luckily it's not that bright full moon. So it helps out just a little bit. So keep those things in mind. Again, allow your eyes to adjust. Like I mentioned earlier, it actually may not be the best tonight to get out and look and view that. That's because of the clouds we'll see across the area. If we see those low-lying clouds and those thunderstorms, again, overnight tonight, you won't be able to see it. But actually, Wednesday night into Thursday, we're hoping for some of those clouds to break up across the area. If they do, you will see that better chance. Again, tonight is technically when it peaks, but still a few nights out from tonight, you'll be able to see it. You will potentially be able to see, if you get good conditions, 50 to 100 meteors an hour. That's about 3 a minute. So just keep your eye to the sky. And if you do see any and you do happen to snap a picture, I know I just mentioned don't be on your phone, but if you're one of those people that do that and get it, we would love to see that. You can always email those into us or use our app. We have a feature on our news app that you can send in some photos and videos. So hopefully you are able to get out within the next few nights. I know tonight with clouds and thunderstorms in the forecast, it may not actually be the best viewing, but hopefully you're able to see some of these beautiful meteors as they last for the next few nights.